Welcome back to stage 2 of this mini project, and in this stage you're going to be configuring the simulated on-premises side of this architecture. So you'll be configuring the pfSense router, and once you've finished you'll have two operational tunnels, one to each of the VPN endpoints within the AWS environment, and this will ensure, at least from the AWS side, that this is a highly available solution. Now, just moving back to the AWS console, you'll need to make sure that this site-to-site VPN connection is in the available state before you continue. So if it's not, go ahead and pause this video and resume it once you do move into an available state. At this point, I'm going to assume that your site-to-site VPN connection is also in an available state. So at this point, we need to move across to the EC2 console. You should have this favorited at the top, so go ahead and right-click and open that in a new tab. Once you're there, go ahead and click on Instances Running, and these are the three instances running within this mini-project. We have the on-premises router, the on-premises server, and the AWS server. So what I want you to do is to go ahead and select the on-premises router. So this is the pfSense router that we're going to be configuring. Now you'll need the authentication details in order to log in, and this is automatically generated. To get those, go ahead and right-click, go to Monitor and Troubleshoot, and then select Get System Log. And this will load in the log of the system, and at the top you'll see EC2-user password changed to, and then the password for this pfSense router. So I want you to go ahead and copy that into your clipboard. Once you've done that, go ahead and click on EC2 at the top, and then go back to Instances Running, select On-Premises Router again, and then click on this link next to Open Address, and this is going to open a new tab and connect to this on-premises router. You might see a security warning because this is using a self-signed certificate. So whatever you need to do in your browser to accept this risk, in my case I need to click on Advanced and then accept the risk and continue. Once I've done that, I'll be asked to sign in to pfSense, and the username is admin, and the password is the password you just copied down into your clipboard. So paste that in and click on sign in. Now you're initially going to see a wizard, and we don't want that, so go ahead and click on the pfSense logo on the top left. You might see a copyright and trademark notice. If you do, just click on accept. And you might see another informational dialogue. If you do, click on close. Now we're going to implement this architecture, and notice how the pfSense router has two network interfaces. It has an interface on the left side, which is the WAN interface, and this is the interface that the VPN connection will connect into. But it also has another interface on the right side, and this is the LAN interface. Now we need to configure the LAN side interface. So to do that, go ahead and click on Interfaces at the top, and then click on Assignments. It will detect that there's another available network port, which is this, so go ahead and click on Add, and that will add this as the LAN interface. Once that's done, click on Save, and now we've added the LAN interface, we need to configure the networking. So to do that, click on Interfaces and then go to LAN, check the box to say Enable Interface, and then under the IP version 4 configuration type, click in the drop-down and select DHCP. And this will mean that the IP address of this interface is dynamically assigned by AWS, and that's okay. In production usage, because this is a router interface, you generally pick a static IP address and then explicitly provide the addressing. But for this demo, we don't need to worry about that. So go ahead, scroll down to the bottom and click on Save, and then click on Apply Changes. And this may appear to hang for a second while those networking changes are being applied. Next, we're going to create the VPN tunnels and IPsec configuration between this on-premises router and AWS. To do that, click on VPN and then select IPsec. Now at this point, do make sure that you have watched my IPsec fundamentals video, which steps through the architecture of IPsec VPNs. If you haven't done, that is linked attached to this video. IPsec VPNs consist of one or more tunnels which are split between phase 1 and phase 2. So the next thing that we'll be doing is to create a phase 1 and phase 2 configuration for each of the AWS side endpoints. So there are four pieces of configuration that we need to perform. Now I'd also recommend at this point that you do have the VPN configuration file open, because we're going to be referring to it for some of the configuration values. And as a reminder, this is the configuration file that you downloaded from the previous stage when you created the site-to-site VPN connection. And if you look through this file, it contains all of the configuration that you'll need for both Tunnel 1 and Tunnel 2. And we're going to start with the Tunnel 1 configuration. So make sure that you've got this file open and you reference IPsec Tunnel 1. So first we're going to create the phase 1 configuration for Tunnel 1. So click on the green button saying plus add P1. So for description, we're going to use AWS-tunnel-AZ1. Make sure that disabled is unchecked, because you want this to be enabled. For the key exchange version, remember we're using Ike version 1. So go ahead and select Ike version 1. For internet protocol, we're using IP version 4. And this tunnel is going to be connecting to the WAN interface. So that's the interface on the left side, the one that's connecting to the public internet. Now for the remote gateway, this is the IP address of endpoint 1 on the AWS side. Now you can get this from this VPN configuration file. If you look under IPsec Tunnel 1 and then under General Information, copy down the IP address for the remote gateway. So this is the AWS side IP address for endpoint 1. So go ahead and enter that under remote gateway. For the authentication method, we're going to use mutual PSK. For negotiation mode, we're going to use main. We're going to leave both the my and peer identifiers as my IP address and peer IP address. Exactly what these do is beyond the scope of this mini project, so just leave these as default. And next we need to enter the pre-shared key, and you can think about this as a long complex password, and this allows the on-premises router and the AWS side infrastructure to authenticate against each other. Now this pre-shared key is again stored in this configuration file because it's something that's generated by AWS. So under the IPsec Tunnel 1, and then under Phase 1 Proposal Authentication, there'll be a line item for pre-shared key. Go ahead and copy that into your clipboard and make sure that you do get all of the characters. And once you've got that, go ahead and paste it under pre-shared key. Now under the encryption algorithm, make sure it's set to AES 128 bits. Under hash, change it to SHA-1, so SHA-1 instead of SHA-256. Again, to confirm, make sure it's set to SHA-1. And then under DH group, go ahead and change it to 21024 bit. Scroll down. Under lifetime, make sure this is set to 28800. Scroll down further still. Make sure that dead peer detection is checked. Make sure that NATCH traversal is set to auto. Make sure delay is set to 10. And then make sure max failures is set to 3. And you'll probably need to change this value. And once you've changed it, go ahead and click on save. And this creates the phase 1 configuration for endpoint 1 at the AWS side. So next we're going to create the matching phase 2 configuration for the phase 1 configuration that we've just created. So I want you to look for AWS Tunnel AZ1, and directly below that you should see a show phase 2 entries. So click that, and then click on plus add P2. For the description, go ahead and use IPsec-tunnel1-AWS-AZ1. This just allows us to match it up to the phase one configuration that's used, as well as which AWS endpoint we're using. For disabled, make sure this is unchecked because we want this to be enabled. Make sure mode is set to tunnel IPv4. For local network, click on the drop-down and select network. Now on the same line, under address, go ahead and enter 192.168.10.0 and set this to /24. This is the private subnet within the simulated on-premises environment, and this is the subnet which we want to be able to access AWS. Under remote network, again, make sure that network is selected, and then enter 10.16.0.0 and change this to /16. So this is the AWS VPC IP range, and this is the IP range that we want this on-premises network to be able to access. Now scroll down. For protocol, make sure this is set to ESP. Make sure that AES is checked and that it's set to 128 bits. Under hash algorithms, make sure that SHA-1 is checked. And click in the PFS key group dropdown and select 21024 bit. The lifetime needs to be 3600. And then scroll down and we're going to configure this keep alive setting. Now this allows us to have this VPN gateway ping an IP address at the AWS side, and this ensures that the VPN connection is active. So what we need to do is to get the IP address of something at the AWS side. So to do that, go back to the EC2 console, select AWS Server A and copy down the private IP version 4 address of AWS Server A. And again, yours will be different. Make sure you use your private address. Move back to pfSense, paste in that address, check this box and click on save. So that's the configuration for the AWS endpoint 1. And now we need to follow that same process, so phase 1 and phase 2 for AWS endpoint 2. So again, click on add P1 at the bottom, and we'll follow the same process. For description, AWS-tunnel-AZ2. Make sure disabled is unchecked. Key exchange version IKEv1. Internet protocol IP version 4. Interface WAN. For the remote gateway, now we need to scroll down and look under IPsec tunnel 2. General configuration, remote gateway. So copy down this IP address. This will be different than the one for IPsec tunnel 1. Paste that into this box. So this is the IP address of endpoint 2 at the AWS side. Scroll down. Authentication method, mutual PSK. Negotiation mode, main. Leave these two drop-downs as the defaults, my IP address and peer IP address, and now we need the pre-shared key for endpoint 2 at the AWS side. So scroll down further, again under IPsec tunnel 2, phase 1 proposal authentication, and then pre-shared key. And again, this will be different than for the IPsec tunnel 1 configuration that you just implemented. So make sure you copy down all of these characters. Paste that into this box. Encryption algorithm AES. Key length 128. For hash, SHA-1. For DH group, 21024 bit. Lifetime needs to be 28800. Dead peer detection is enabled, NAT traversal is auto, delay is 10, and again change max failures to 3 and click on save. So that's the phase 1 configuration for the second AWS VPN endpoint. So again, we need to create the phase 2 configuration for this phase 1 configuration. So make sure that you look for AWS-tunnel-AZ2 and under that, click on show phase 2 entries and then click on add P2. Now for the description, use IPsec-tunnel2-AWS-AZ2. So we can see that this is for Tunnel 2 and for the Endpoint 2 at the AWS side. Make sure Disabled is unchecked because we want this to be enabled. And for mode, Tunnel IPv4. Under Local Network, change this to Network. And again, we're going to put the IP address of the private subnet within the simulated on-premises environment. So this is 192.168.10.0 and set to /24. Under Remote Network, make sure it's set to Network. And the IP address that goes here is the AWS VPC, so 10.16.0.0 and then /16. And you'll need to change this to /16. The protocol needs to be ESP. Make sure AES is checked and 128 bits is selected. Under hash algorithm, make sure that SHA-1 is selected. For PFS key group, change that to 2/1024-bit. Lifetime needs to be 3600. Scroll down, check the enable periodic keep alive check, and again, we're going to need the IP address of something at the AWS side. So go back to instances, make sure AWS server A is selected, copy down its private IP, go back to pfSense and paste that into this box and click on save. Now at this point, we've created the phase one and phase two configurations for both of these tunnels. So that's the connection to endpoint one and endpoint two at the AWS side. So that's the architecture that's shown on screen now. Now the only thing that remains is to apply these changes. So moving back to pfSense, click on apply changes. And then go to status, IPsec, and we're going to manually connect both of these tunnels. So click on connect P1 and P2s for both of these lines. So first the top one, and then the bottom one. And after a while, you should see established under both of these lines. If you don't, that means some of your configuration is wrong, and you should verify that. But if you do see established under both of these lines, then that means that you have this architecture implemented. So tunnels between the simulated on-premises side and both of the AWS VPN endpoints. Now this still won't work because there's additional routing and security configuration that we need to perform in the next stage of this mini project. But for now, that's everything we need to do. So go ahead and complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next stage of this mini project.